always been a bit wary of the great prices section in Sainsbury's, because I saw something on clearance here once and it was still normal price in Argos, which is now what Sainsbury's own. So I'm gonna check that out in Argos in a minute and see if it's the same price or not, or even lesser or more. Pretty sure this is the same one, Sony HT-SF150 120 watt 2 channel sound bar Bluetooth, £99. I'm going to go back to the other one now and see if it says the same thing. Yeah, same thing in Sainsbury's, just actually 30 seconds away you can save £26. It's exactly the same thing. That's not the first time I've seen something like that in Sainsbury's and Argos. It's all the same company now. It's I think it's something Watchdogs should look into. I'm in the dead part of Chiswick. All the way down there you'll see Carpet Right, which is also closed. There's only a cafe or a restaurant, whatever, and this sales and marketing suite that's open. And I think it's because it's some kind of Chiswick thing. They're not allowed to put wooden boards up, but everything's just closed. And the ceiling's leaking in there. And this is a separate unit, but they've knocked it into one big one. Obviously, you can tell from the outside it was two separate places. And this is open. They've got the shutters down, but they don't look very busy. This is another couple of... This is the only bit that is boarded up. It's weird. And then we've got another closed down shop. I don't know why they choose not to put boards up, because this looks absolutely awful. This is my Monday Meander. It's a shorter video today because I've got to go to work later. There's a blast from the past. Look, this shows you how dead this area of Chiswick's been, which is daft because it's on the High Street. But it's really because there's just not that many shops to fill these units anymore. This looks the worst. Obviously, this one's been closed one of the longest amounts of time. Still even got the quick drop box. Now, if you don't know what this is, current YouTube, back in the day, before YouTube, you had to rent your entertainment from a video shop, and it was very, very boring. I never actually enjoyed walking around a video shop. I found it quite dull, and just looking at endless boxes. Now, this is an old fine food since 1991. Well, not anymore. Sorry, we are now closed. There you are. And yeah, you can get home delivery, but it's closed. 5 stars, but it's closed. And but they've still left up the "Do you want a job?" Yeah. And there's this restaurant that's still open. And I'm gonna get to what used to be called Carpet Right, but according to the sign now it's just Car Right. And this is just an absolute mess in here. This one's been closed a long time. Iron a bean, but the carpet shop has a really horrible carpet. Even when it was open, that is a pretty ugly carpet. And not in very good condition. So that is that. And then there's this bed shop. Anyway, I'm under Meander. So I'm going to walk around. Then all of a sudden, gets to full on business. The expensive Turnian guy haircutting salon. Do you know what? I'm looking out for the old board game, sorry, but the older version of it. I know they still make it. But I'm going to have to go into charity shops and that lot. And that charity shop smell, you know, it's a smell of its own, isn't it? Now, even though apparently there's all this time of uncertainty, what a load of rubbish all that is, but they've still got time to replace bus stops, pointlessly. I don't get it. I might have a look in Sainsbog's. Yeah, I'm going to have a look in Sainsbog's, I think. It's bank holiday, so I've got to make sure that I keep an eye on the time. I've got a couple of hours before I need to go to work anyway. But yeah, I'm going to have a look in Sainsbog's. All this rubbish, because normally there's a little-ish sort of market stall thing going on there, usually, but not on a... He's just done the awful thing where people, like, snot out the nose. Dare to get. I don't want people to do that. It's just filthy. This is where one of them stupidly small Argos is, where there's hardly any stock available. Getting a chicken and sweet corn sarnie, some knickknacks. I love knickknacks, but I haven't had them in ages. Getting some knickknacks, spicy ones. And also some Rabina. I don't know why, but I feel a bit childish buying a Rabina. I always associate Rabina as being a drink that very young kids drink, rather than grown-ups. That's Cafe Nero. Cafe Nero. Probably prefers to be pronounced Cafe Nero. Cafe Nero is how it's called. Third biggest chain, I believe, of coffee chains in the UK. And because it's the third biggest, it often manages to avoid any of the anger about recycling and waste food and this, that and the other. Pardon me. I've just necked that meal deal and I'm halfway through my Rabina. Yeah, because Costa is absolutely everywhere, as is Starbucks. But Cafe Nero seems to get away with doing its own thing, really. You hear nothing about it in the news ever. You hear nobody talk about it. It must be doing reasonably well, because it's still in business. I mean, coffee is generally overpriced everywhere now, isn't it? Of course, the other two places where you buy coffee from is Greg's, which is there, and Mackie D's. Although I've never bought a coffee from Greg's, so I don't know what it's going to be like. And it's too hot to have a coffee right now, so I'm not going to have a coffee. I'm having my Rabina. Got Waitrose, which does its free coffee for customers. Yeah. So in a minute you'll see some people sat outside enjoying the coffee they got for free from Waitrose. Heavy Tulip, as I like to call it. I hope I'm not talking with a sandwich stuck in my teeth. Paper chase, I might have a look in paper chase. And there's a Robert Dyas as well. I just think it sounds posh when you say Robert Dyas. Yes, there's something to Robert Dyas. No, I'm not going to go in paper chase. Yeah, I am. Another closed down cafe there. I'm going to go to my favourite shop. I love paper chase. See if there's out to get. I resisted the urge. I actually got the bus to Chiswick today. I could have walked, but it's terrible weather, as you can see. I can't. Oh, shade, lovely. The thing I like about Chiswick is the High Street, whatever it's called, has got really big, well-established sycamore trees, which block out all the sun except the small gaps in between, as you just saw that. Yeah, I'm gonna have a look in Robert Dyas. See what there is. Not really into water features. And wrong sand next to it, it's not cleaning in process, although it does sound like someone's having a wee. Not really wanted in there either. It's quite polleny out today, actually. Bits keep going into my eyes, which is quite annoying. It might just be dust, I don't know, but everyone's doing it, look, like just bits everywhere. Let's get some sunglasses or something. I've got loads of them at home. You never I say you never remember to bring them out. I never remember to bring my sunglasses out. Look, more closed down shops there, look. I don't think they've ever been open, them shops. These ones behind me are just shut because it's Bank Holiday Monday. There's a shop here that I saw, and it was just absolutely full of flies flying around. I think I accidentally deleted the video, but there was just loads of flies just like flying around. Yeah, I think someone's been in and swept most of them up. It was absolutely vile. And there's still a fly flying around in there. I think there's something dead or rotten in there. But it was much worse the other day. I'll see if I can find the video. It was absolutely rank. And... so this is Chiswick on a bank holiday Monday. Vandalism there. I'm trying to smash the way into the shop. Now this is Gill's Bakery, and it's a chain. There's quite a few of them in posh areas of London, but I've never actually been into one, but I have tried some of the stuff. Someone I used to work with, their second job was working at Gill's, and it was really nice. It's like makes cakes and breads and that sort of stuff. It's a bakery, like Patisserie Valerie, just less fraudy, really. That's it. I know I've covered Chiswick quite a lot, but it's just because it's so close to me. There used to be a McDonald's in Chiswick where it closed down. It's one of the few places where it used to be. And there's Mountain Warehouse. You see, I thought Mountain Warehouse was expensive, but it's actually quite good. That's where I got the t-shirt I was wearing yesterday from. Twig just fell off a tree. Oliver Bonus is a weird shop. It sells clothes and teapots and vases. It's the most weirdest shop ever. It just sells a bit of everything. It's one of them shops you'd expect to close down in a recession, but it just didn't. Pizza Express with a disgustingly dirty awning. If it sells food, they should be cleaning the awning. And the same goes for Costa, actually. I know there's a lot of pollen in the air, but yeah, look, it's all green on top of that Costa look. But it's dry. It's just dusty, I think. No, it's actually a bit grubby as well. There's a good couple of days. No, there's a good couple of weeks of grub on there. That's not very good. It's after working in retail such a long time, it's first impressions, isn't it? And if you walk into somewhere that sells food and the awning and the signage is dirty, falling to pieces, covered in bird crap, whatever, it just doesn't give a very good impression, does it? There's the shop that I do not shop in anymore because Marks and Spencer's is just been run into the ground by terrible management. We'll think that closing stores will help it make it profitable, which it will not. How about just listening to your customers? And I'm looking at Poundland. Yeah, I am gonna. I thought that was a kid bouncing a ball then, but it's just someone fixing yet another new bus stop for whatever reason into Chiswick. I mean, what's wrong with the old ones? There's an old one right next to it, look. They're swapping them ones for these ones. I think the only difference is now they've got a screen on. Anyway, I'm gonna have a look in Poundland. I had to get out of there. There was a couple of tourists and the kid just had its arms full of crap and kept dropping it everywhere, then just shoved it into its mum's arms, and then the mum just dropped everything everywhere, including makeup, which then broke into bits on the floor, and then she just dumped. So that's not very nice, is it? I'm so glad I don't work in retail anymore. So glad. This is another restaurant that closed down called Pain. Now I know it's meant to be pronounced Pan, but it's spelt like Pain, and it's closed anyway, so. And they're getting run over by a Porsche because I wasn't looking where I was going. Oops. Silly of me, wasn't it? Always look when crossing the road. Ooh, the Crown, Chiswick. And that's rather posh, doesn't it? And let's go into a posh pub. And
is pretty much it really. There's somewhere else that's closed. I want this Daniel footwear. It's closed. Should have an ogle in here, so it looks like.
Can you see it? I hope you saw that, because I've got it on the wrong camera really, to ogle into shop windows. Oh, I need to pay my rent. It's not due to the first, but if I get it done now, it's out the way, innit? Then I'll have to do it on my day off. Open bank holiday, 11 till 5. Good, good, good. I've only just noticed there's another Cafe Nero there. It's really unusual to see a Cafe Nero twice on the same street. Very, very surprised. It's weird because even though it's bank holiday, it's still quite busy. I can smell burgers. No, that's Oxfam, that's a charity shop. But you've got to have a lot of money to spend it in there. That's stupid. It went all posh. And it's gone from being one of them charity shops where you just find stuff to being really over-the-top posh. Which is daft. It's like charity begins at home sometimes. And they'd have made more money off of me for sure. Anyway. I've never been down this side street. I know I have been down it. I went down it once. I was knelt down it that I liked, so... Yeah, I remember now. I think I'm confusing it with another side street. And this is like the never changing to the Green Man crossing. So everyone just walks over it in their own time. See, now it's just changed to green. Beep, 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 beep. Joan the Juice. This used to be the, I think it used to be the Odd Bins. Which reminded me of Patsy, how absolutely fabulous. And there's the cow shed. I wonder if that's where I can smell the burgers from. I don't know. Our Roadhouse Brasserie. Brasserie, isn't it? It's a brasserie. It's a brasserie. How posh am I getting? Oh, well, just gotta go pay my rent. I'll be back in a minute. I was gonna have to get paid another day. There was a stupid, annoying kid just... And it was a kid as well, probably about 13 or 14. Just monopolising the bank... person, bank teller's time. Could think of the word then. And, I know it's a bank holiday. But there was three other members of staff walking around and they could have just jumped on. But they didn't. I think I'm pretty much done for today actually. I mean, I didn't have the time to stand around. Oh, there's Feather and Black in the background. I know they've got a job there. Feather and Black. And where is it? Where is it? There. It's a bed, duvet, bedroom furniture-y sort of shop. Quite posh. And I decided not to work there. I decided to do the chocolate shop instead. Oh, was that the... No, that's not right. I was actually thinking of leaving the chocolate shop. Yeah, I was already at the chocolate shop and I was going to work there instead. Good job I didn't, because it went into administration and got bought up by a rival and they've closed the shop anyway, so that was a good job that I didn't get the job there. There's nothing else I can really say about Chiswick really. Some kind of plant shop. Is that a plant shop? No, it's not. It's just some sort of overplanted coffee shop. The coffee shop for parents. Okay then, well, it's a coffee shop for parents, so I'm not welcome. That's a way to alienate a lot of customers, isn't it? A coffee shop for parents? Why call it that? Why not just make it fill it full of baby stuff and whatever? Or do whatever you wanted to do and just... Oof. That's just stupid. I'm not offended, you know, because everyone's offended about everything these days, isn't it? I'm not offended. I'm just annoyed at the stupid business idea of calling it a coffee shop for parents. It's like, well, what happens if someone just happens to be passing by and wants to buy a coffee? I'm going to feel alienated now and not want to go there. This is Chiswick Lane. Quite a busy crossing. Just gonna go home now. And eyes itchy. I think all the trees must be pollinating, and there is a lot of sycamore trees, but that's what I like, it's nice and shady. The cloud is covering over the sun now. There's a plane. If you saw it. Can I cross yet? I'm just gonna cross now. Sod it. Oh, look, now there's a car. And now we'll come across again. That car's been in a bit of an accident. It's missing its... It's missing the front. Well, it's missing its indicator. Oh, it's an Audi. Of course it's an Audi if the front of it's crashed in. It's missing a headlight rather than the indicator. Although I'm surprised it's got an indicator that works, because, strange fact, many Audi drivers don't know indicators exist. Rampant dance company. I never see anyone enter or leave. A site entrance? That's new. Has it been closed down all that time? I don't know. It's just very, very, that'll explain actually why I've never seen anyone come and go. Maybe it's been closed down all that time. KFC is somewhere where you'll never see me. The Good Wine Shop. Yeah. What happens if you buy a bottle of bad wine from the Good Wine Shop? Hemfield Road. Every time I see a street sign now in London, I always think of it as what the announcer says on the bus. I always think of her voice in my head. Is that weird? No, obviously if you're not from London, you probably don't know what I'm talking about, because it's quite a London-y thing, isn't it? The calling out of every bus stop. But that's what I've in mind. Just get the bus home. I might get the bus home. Typical me, I always turn the camera off when something interesting happened. This car here would just stop in the middle of the road, or the taxi behind it, and there was rowing in the middle of the street. And I missed it. That always happens. Like, I never have my phone out at the right time. Never. Oh, well. Oh, I missed it. It's quite a funny stop speeding sign advert campaign. But actually, it looks quite funny. Is it on the back of this bus? Oh! If I see it again, hopefully I have my camera out once again on time. Since I've walked this way, I might as well cut through, what's it called, Raven's Court Park. It's the law that when you go through a tunnel, you've got to go, hoo-hoo, echo, hoo-hoo, echo, echo. Yeah, I'm an adult. Dead tree. Oh well, plenty more where they came from. Loads of trees. The cafe's open. That's nice, isn't it? And that's it really. There's loads of fields and stuff. And why have people still got coats on? It's warm. Like leather jackets, coats, really? Just put the coats off. oh my god, there's even some woman not only with a coat on, but a big massive F off hat. Like a winter hat. And since when do I emphasise the letter H? An hat? A winter hat? Oh, shut up laughing. I don't deserve to laugh wearing a coat in this weather. It's warm. Anyway. Oh, that's them things. It's just... I've seen this for ages. What you do with these is... stick them on your nose. Do kids still do that? Remember we had more time as kids. I remember at primary school the trick was to see how many you could stick to your face. Yeah, because they're really sticky.
Anyway,
I think that's everything. Thanks for watching. Scrass. See you when I see ya. Bye, Bellamy. Bye.